the surge, the hurricane of money that comes out. But you don't see what comes before the storm. Which I don't do that much. But if I do anything, I've got any blood to cut it, it's apple. I hope I can see how my fighters see what comes before the apple. Because you already know at the end of the forest, is coming forward with. But before that, there's some warmth, something that shows you some delay, something there before that happens. And that's what I was hoping to do with Marshall and to see what that was. Again, before I don't know, right, now I'm too busy. The air gets sucked out of the place. You can feel it, and the sky is darkening. But before the explosion of ability comes from Manny, and obviously the resulting in punches, there's some preliminary to that. there's habits. Come before that, there's action, there's, and those are things that we've tried to look at, be aware of, and are aware of. Now can we do something about it? That's the question that puts me up in there. You know? Man, I wish, I would take the zapper for a Christmas party. I might actually want to do this again if I had a Christmas party. But nobody does. But it makes it hard to do this because I can only see my parents. You wake up and then you go to bed every night. Just what I need to do to prepare my friend for what he's about to do. Will I fail? And it's a weight. Yeah, I'm not complaining, I'm blessed. I'm blessed, I'm in a position to say, I'm very fortunate that I get it. And I'm very privileged. I get it. But it doesn't mean that you don't feel what comes with that decision. You care about the human being. You have that responsibility. Very much like being a parent again. I wouldn't want to be a parent again. Yeah. That's a beautiful case. One got two law school type child, the other one works at the age. I get free stuff. But I want to be, I never picture myself holding a lot of money. 32-year-old son. That is now. I have to guide him. I have to make sure that he gets food okay. He gets hungry. It is what it is. I know it's true. All the things that we wanted to put in place for times on Saturday night, that we can be okay, and that I didn't fail him. Because to be a decent friend, and I can't be a decent friend, but to be a decent friend, you have to, obviously, to be decent in anything, you have to care about it. But I'm just saying, you do need to care, and you have to know something about it. You have to have some experience, some background, understand the importance of what you're doing. And then you have to have in this case, a really good student, a really good athlete, someone who has skills, someone who has a really good intellect, that can understand the big thing you're trying to do. That comes from not doing awareness and toughness and all those things. And at the end of the day, the most important thing, you have that trust. And when somebody gives you that trust, I don't know how many people you have to trust. I'm going to tell you, when that happens, you really get your trust. That's a beautiful thing to say. Because you don't want to fail it.
I appreciate it.
I think you guys look like nice guys, but I wouldn't trust you beyond until I knew I could. I wouldn't. I mean, it's because I don't know what you're doing with those bitches. But when somebody calls you, that's the human shield that puts it down. It's like, let me check.
Let me check. And I got 15. I got 5 kids here. But whatever you say, I'm going to fire
you. You better be right. You better fucking be right. And, I'm not concerned because I'm just going to take what there was a reason why these are things that we made this relationship was to just do a long term contract. And I did a one time contract. A lot of people didn't understand. Why did you do that? Obviously not a smart business plan, but it was a proper human business. I acknowledge my values and make sure that I believe that fight for fighting system needs to be what makes sense for the business. And I didn't want to be in a position where if I didn't think that I would be betraying him by walking away. It's a terrible feeling. I felt it more times than I like to. And I want someone to do it. So I knew what it was. The only reason I'm doing it was for you. You know that. I mean, and I feel now we don't need anything. But at that point, I have to think about this. I said, I don't want to have a long-term situation. I want to see the goals of that. I want to be able to tell you whether or not you have to each find what I think should be the future, whether there should be a future. And I don't want to be in a position where, as I said, I walk away from my my commitment. It was understood in that way. But you didn't get out and say, oh, now you're not hurt. I don't want to be in that position. So to your question, I mean, all those things. To me, when you have a 32-year-old fighter, I think at least it's only for me that you should go about your business in a, a 32-year-old. That means maybe less sparring. I use 18-ounce gloves. And from what I find out about this business, you just know, nobody uses 18-ounce gloves. So everybody thinks it was for condition. I don't do it for condition. Listen, does it have an impact in that area? Yeah, it does. Because the legs, by the way, I tell you, the head feels a lot lighter when you go to 8-ounce gloves. That's good for yourself, right? At least I gave you something. But the reason I really do it is I want to lessen the impact of punches in the gym. That's why I really do it. But it does have obviously the advantage on the physical side. It does have it does help you from that standpoint as far as conditioning, but it wasn't chosen. What did I see in Tim? Remember Tim? Timmy Paul? So I guess his voice was such a charming voice. And So I asked a question from my perspective, it makes sense to ask.
So you press button on the phone, obviously you got
saved. I mean, the problem is that you know why you have to have
that. That's the thing.
And you don't get on this case, you know? All of a sudden you said, you're down. So the baby went to you went a little different.
I'm going to train it.
You train it. And I told him why that is. The guy thinks, and not just here, this kind of media. They will act like the thing.
How did that say? Yeah.
So we went down low, they came out, so I explained to him. And he thanked me. And then, he's like, he's going to call you the trainer. I said, what are you talking about?
And we took a break, like after we did a commercial.
And, I'm not even thinking in those terms. A couple weeks later, he called me. Ready, it's Tim Bradley. I want to know if you trained. And I didn't have any thoughts that I would get back into training. But I couldn't give him an answer. I told him, I kind of almost gave him a no. But I said, let me just, I'm not really ready to do this, you know. I haven't given any thought to do this, you know. I said, I understand, you know. And it's up to you, right? If you want to. So I talked to my family, and I talked to my daughter, and she showed that it was a good investment to put her through law school. She told me, Dad, even though you guys might not agree with it, but she said, you're a really, really good broadcaster. And actually, she said more than that. She's my daughter. She said, you're the best. Which, of course, daughters say those things. She said, but the essence of what you are is a teacher. And you're not teaching anymore. And it'd be a shame to not teach anymore, but you still have a chance. And I know why you don't teach anymore, because you chose the Beckham, you won the heavyweight title, you committed 2.5 years to him. And at the end of the day, he dishonored his agreement. He betrayed his commitment. And he decided he didn't want to come to the States to train anymore. And I had to train in the States during the time. That's why we did it for 2.5 years. We had a deal. When I'm working for ESPN, we train here. When I'm not, I go to Russia and eat borscht. So she said, but because he failed himself, it would be a shame. He failed himself in not keeping his word. It would be a shame that keeps you from ever teaching again. Because you have an ability to teach and a passion for it. And I said, I don't even know if I have a passion for it anymore. She said, well, why don't you find out? So I went out to Palm Springs for a couple of days, spent a couple of days with Jimmy, and I saw him as a father of 5 children. I saw him as a husband. And I saw a person that I liked and that I felt good to be around. And I went to the gym with him, and he was excited, he was enthused. He couldn't wait to learn things. And listen, there's not a lot that I can, I don't have a big part of this because he was already a champion. Let's not forget that. But he was at a point where he was getting hit with punches, certain punches, whatever reason.
at this point in his life, he's getting hit with some punches that obviously, you know, you don't want to get hit with. That were bringing him to the cliff where he had to use that great inner strength that he had. And you don't want to have to use that all the time. So there were some things to work on. And I showed him the things that I thought were important. And he asked me to, he said, I think you should stay in this business. I don't think you should be able to teach still. And would you teach me? Because I need you.
Hey, Teddy.
And when he said, I need you, let me just finish this. When he said, I need you, I think it spoke to the most basic part of, if I am a teacher, and my daughter's right, it spoke to the most basic part. And I don't put no merit badge on myself.
Right.
Because I don't deserve my money. I'm far, far away from that. But I do try to care about the right things. And I think at the core of being a teacher, there's something about helping somebody, contributing. There's something that you can contribute. You can help somebody get better. And that's worthwhile. There's something beyond what you normally do that when you can help somebody else, obviously it helps you. But if you can help somebody else that is asking for help, there's a feeling of just
gratification.
That you've done something worthwhile, something beyond the normal realm of a job, and you have a privilege that you don't always get. A privilege of being able to add to somebody, to help somebody, to add to someone's life a little bit. And it awoke in that.
Right.
That I said, you know, it spoke to me. It drove me a little bit. And I felt that I was actually happy in the gym again with just a fighter. Being able to teach, there was a goodness to it again that I forgot there was.
So teachers like to see growth in their pupils, right? So what is the growth that you've seen in Bradley since you came on board?
Just hopefully being more definitive in what he does, a more definitive identity when he gets in the ring. And he's not Jake Romano 1 minute, Pernell Whittington the next. Just more definitive about his approach and with his technique, with the talent, how he uses the talent, and how streamlined it is. Hopefully,
it looked like he places shots better now under you. Because with Rios, he wasn't swinging wild looping shots. His shots were straight, on point, and accurate. And his balance was good, as well.
Thank you.
So you did a great job, Teddy.
Thank you for the banner.
I hope it shows.